Hey folks, today we're going to take a look at Ansys SpaceClaim Direct Modeler, specifically talking about the shelling and infilling tools for STL models. And this has particular application in the 3D printing realm, where the cost of printing materials can be quite high. And so you may find it advantageous to print only shells of bodies instead of complete solid bodies, thereby lowering your printing costs. And so on the screen, we have an STL model of the Stanford Bunny. You can check it out online. Because of its unique organic shape, it's frequently used for benchmarking graphics hardware or CAD architecture. And so if we zoom in, we can see it's comprised of a million small triangular facets defining its STL shape. And so anytime I bring an STL model into SpaceClaim, one of the first things I like to do is check the facets. But before I go there, I'll point out that this facets tab is not natively available in SpaceClaim. It comes with an additional add-on license with a small, modest upcharge. But once you have it, you can come in your SpaceClaim options. And on the left, we'll click on license and check the box for STL prep. You'll then have this additional tab for the facets work. So one of the first things I'd like to do is to check the facets. So I'm going to activate this tool, and the memo is telling me to click a faceted body to check for problems. So I'll click on the bunny. And we get this report that says no geometry problems were found. And actually, this is quite rare for an STL model. Usually they come in with various problems like overconnected edges, holes, non-manifold vertices, and so on. Tools are available in SpaceClaim to fix all those things, but they're beyond the scope of this video, so I cleaned up the model beforehand. So I'll go ahead and close this, hit the escape key to kill that command. And so now we're going to take a look at the shell tool. I can activate the shell tool in this modify group. And the memo then tells us to click solid or faceted bodies to remove faces and shell. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the bunny, and we notice to the left we have various options available to us. I'm going to leave the thicken direction at inside, which means the tool is going to take the exterior of the bunny and thicken it in the inward direction. I'm going to set the thickness at some arbitrary value, 0.1, and hit enter. Now for viewing these, I want to deselect the feet of the bunny so that once the operation is complete, we can easily see inside the shell just to confirm that it carried out like we thought it would. And I can do that with this tool guide. Now I'm going to snap the bunny into the positive Z direction by clicking on my triad here. And with the tool guide active, I can box select the feet to remove them from the shelling operation. I rotate around and I immediately notice that many facets were not chosen in that box select. And the reason is I didn't first come down here and change my box selection to through. So if I re-perform the box select, rotate around, I now notice that I got STL facets through the entire thickness, which is what I wanted. So I can now click the green check and just wait a moment and the shelling operation will complete. Hit the escape key now, and we can rotate around and see the shell of the bunny at approximately 0.1 inches thick, just like we expected. So now I'm going to undo that operation with the undo button here. Hit the escape key to kill the active command. Now I'm going to re-perform that, showing the infill options for the shell tool. But before I do that, I need to point out that the infill only occurs in the Z direction. So in this view, it would be right to left and left to right. If I instead wanted it to occur from head to toe, I first need to move the bunny into a different orientation. And I can do that on the Design tab with the Move tool. So I'll activate the tool, click the faceted body in the Structure tree, and I can grab this red rotational vector and dynamically rotate the bunny to any angle. If I hit the spacebar mid-operation, I can then type in a discrete value and hit enter to snap to that rotation. Now a quick tip, if I undo that, a quick tip is to double click the red rotational vector, which automatically snaps it 90 degrees instantly. so it saves you from a few keyboard strokes. I'll hit the escape key to kill the move command, and we now see that the infill is going to occur from head to toe in the Z direction. I can now come back to the Facets tab to show the shelling operation with the infill option. So I first activate the tool and click the bunny to start. In the options, I'm going to leave the thicken direction at inside and the thickness as 0.1 inches. If I scroll down, I can change my infill type to basic, and I have various options to choose from. In this video, I'll choose the 2D hexagonal pattern, scroll down further, and I'll set some parameters for that infill. We'll set the fill at 10% and the thickness at 0.02. Because of the cross calculations between these various parameters, I'll come back and reset the fill at 10%, and we can see a preview on the screen of the infill. Now I want to again remove the feet so we can see better inside once the shelling operation is complete. So I'm going to go ahead and activate this tool guide and box select the feet to remove them from the shelling operation. If I rotate around, I notice that I got the STL facets through the entire thickness, and that's because my box selection was still set as through. So I click the green check, and in a moment we'll have the shelled out bunny. Escape key will kill that command, and we can rotate around and see the infill on the bunny. If I click this X axis, hold control and click the Y axis, and hit the keyboard key for X, which is the shortcut for cross-section mode, I can look at the interior of the bunny and see the hexagonal infill pattern. The D keyboard key will take me back to 3D mode, and if I undo escape key to kill that shell command, if I undo, I can show the infill option with a custom image, and that's what I'm going to show next. So now let's take a look at how we can apply a custom infill to the model. The first thing we need to do is import an image that represents the infill pattern. So I'll first rotate the bunny slightly so I can get better view of the world origin. I'll click the X axis, hold control, click the Y axis, and then on the design tab, I can go into sketch mode on that plane. In sketch mode, I can then insert a file that represents that image. If you can't see the file, you may need to change your file filter. Select a file and choose open. Place it anywhere on the sketch plane. You can then snap it into plan view. With the vectorize image tool, you can click the image and create an outline of the image. Escape key will kill that command. We can turn the image off in the tree, and we're left with the curves that represent the outline of the image. On the design tab, I can come back to 3D mode and use the fill tool with a box select to fill in and create a surface. If I turn off the curves, I now see the surface left. Escape key will kill that fill tool. Now the size of this surface represents the exact size of the infill, and so obviously this is way too big. We can use the pull tool to scale it though. So activate the pull tool, click the surface body, and activate the scale body tool guide. It's telling me to pick an anchor to scale the body from. So I'll arbitrarily choose this corner, and then I can drag in white space to scale it. If I hit the space bar mid-operation, I can type in any discrete value, hit enter, and it will rescale. Escape key will kill that command. We're now ready to carry out the custom infill. So if we go back to the Facets tab, we can activate our shell tool. Click the bunny to start, and then take a look at our options. I'm going to leave thicken direction at inside and the thickness at 0.1. For the infill, I'm going to choose custom. And we now get a new tool guide here, which permits me to choose the surface that represents the infill pattern. I'll click the infill pattern in white space, and there's various options below to specify how that pattern is carried out during the infill. I'm going to leave them at their defaults, but I'll set the thickness at 0.05. Hit enter, and then I'll go ahead and click the green check to carry out the infill operation. And after a moment, we'll see that it has infilled with the image that we chose. Hit the escape key to kill that command. We can turn off our surface just to remove it from the workspace. I can now rotate the model so I can get better view of the world origin. If I click the X-axis, hold Control, click the Y-axis, come back to the Design tab, I can go into cross-section mode and have a better view of the shell infill. So if you look closely, you can see the pattern of the image that we chose. I can now come back to 3D mode with this button here to show the entire bunny. And that concludes our video on shelling and infilling. Thanks for watching.